Dear students, today we are going to discuss about the Ministry of Tourism, Government of India, their marketing efforts, especially to the overseas also, and the overall structure of this discussion would be objectives, introduction, as well as the background. Then we will discuss about the role of Ministry of Tourism, Government of India, which include the functions of Ministry of Tourism, as well as marketing and promotion schemes of government, which include the domestic market and overseas market. And finally, we will sum up the discussion. So far as objectives are concerned, by studying this and discussing this, we will get an insight about Ministry of Tourism, Government of India. And after going through to this, you will be ascertain the role of Ministry of Tourism for the development of tourism in the country, as well as to understand the Ministry of Tourism, what are the functions of the Ministry of Tourism, and to learn about the marketing promotion strategy of Ministry of Tourism for domestic purpose as well as for the overseas markets also. When we talk about the introduction, I would like to inform you that there are 6 blocks of this TS1. We are trying to make an attempt to familiarize you with the different concept of marketing of services and service product. When we talk about like tourism, as such, in India, Ministry of Tourism play a vital role to promote India as a tourist destination. The contents of this unit are based upon the material related to the Ministry of Tourism, Government of India. As such, Ministry of Tourism is the nodal agency to formulate national policies and programs for the development and promotion of tourism. In the process, the ministry consults and collaborate with other stakeholders in the sector, including various central ministries, agencies, state governments, union territory administration, and the representatives of private sector. The domestic and overseas field offices also play a vital role for promotion of tourism in the country and outside. They are also involved in monitoring the progress of implementation for the projects sanctioned by the Ministry of Tourism, Government of India. The background of this, in fact, Ministry of Tourism is a branch of Government of India. It is an apex body for the formulation and administration of the rules, regulations relating to the development and promotion of tourism in India and abroad. The government's development agenda is to provide inclusive growth and ensure a future with the quality job. Travel and tourism, which already supports 1 in every 10 jobs in the planet, is a dynamic engine of employment opportunity. Moreover, 1 in every 5 jobs created during the last 5 years has been linked to travel and tourism. Government efforts are now focused upon fast-track infrastructure development and promoting tourism digitally also. The recent key initiatives Ministry of Tourism has undertaken, definitely it will foster the growth of tourism industry in India, and that include e-visa facility extended to more than 160 countries, with relaxed application windows, duration and number of entry norms, launched Incredible India 2.0 campaign with market-specific content and advertising, planned to set up 5 special tourism zones in partnership with the states, new national tourism policy to be launched, that will soon the government will take up the measures. Under Swadesh Darshan scheme, the government has identified 15 circuits on a specific theme for the development. During this year, 18-19, a total of 7 projects worth of 384 crore 67 lakhs were sanctioned under the scheme. Under Prasad scheme, 25 religious sites have been identified for the development, and the Ministry of Tourism has already released 83.24 crore rupees for this project. I'm talking about the funding up to March 2018. India's first adventure tourism guidelines covering 29 land, air and water-based activities, detailing out the role of a guide, important equipment required, operating instructions, risk mitigation, medical safety and other. It's very important about the adventure tour policy. In September 2018, first ever India Tourism Mart 18 was organized in partnership with the FAITH, Federation of Associations in Indian Tourism and Hospitality, which is a prominent body of the trade partners and the practitioners. Ministry of Tourism has launched the Swachh Paryatan mobile app and 24/7 tourist helpline in 12 international languages. Dear students, so far as role of the Ministry of Tourism is concerned, the growing influence of tourism sector as an economic powerhouse and its potential as a tool for the development are irrefutable. Not only does the tourism sector spread its growth, it also improves the quality of people's lives with its capacity to create large-scale employment of diverse kind and foreign exchange earning with the multiplier impact on the economy. It supports environmental protection, diverse cultural heritage and strengthen peace in the world. Facilitation as well as strengthening of tourism in India is the main objective of Ministry of Tourism. Augmenting tourist infrastructure, which is very important, easing of visa regime, assurance of quality standards in services of tourism. When we talk about the projection of the country as a 365 days tourist destination, promotion of sustainable tourism, etc. are some of the policy area which needs to be constantly worked upon to increase and facilitate tourism in India. Dear students, the functions of the Ministry of Tourism are also very important. We can categorize them, the functions related to the policy matters, which include development policies, different incentives, external assistance, manpower development, promotion and marketing, yes, investment facilitation, which is very important, growth strategies. This include further planning, coordination with other ministries and departments, different states, union territory administration, and of course, the regulation. And when we talk about the regulation, this include standards, guidelines, infrastructure, product development, central assistance, distribution of tourism products, research analysis, monitoring is also very important, and evaluation. Dear students, international cooperation and external assistance is also very important when we talk about the functions. International bodies, bilateral agreements, external assistance, foreign technical collaboration, legislation and parliamentary work, establishment matters. There is a long list of the functions, by the way. Overall review of the functioning of the field offices, those are based at the different locations. Vigilance matters, official language, implementation of official language policy, even including the VIP references. Budget is very important, budget coordination and related matters. Then plan coordination is also very important. And of course, overseas marketing work, which generally called OM. Welfare, grievances and protocol is another function important of Ministry of Tourism. These are the basic functions, but beside this, Ministry of Tourism has certain related functions also, like assistance in the formulation of policies by providing feedback from the field, offices, monitoring of plan projects and assisting in the plan formulation, coordination of the activities of the field offices and their supervision regulations. The functions also include the approval and classification of hotels, restaurants, of course, incredible India bed and breakfast units, which is very important. You know, approval of travel agents, tour operators, tourist transport operators. There are inspection, quality control, guide service is also another important function. And of course, the different complaints and redressal and infrastructure development, release of incentives, tourist facilitation and information. So convention and conferences are also very important area. Another important functional area is the human resource development, developing HRD institutions like hotel management and IITTM, setting standards and guidelines, which include the publicity and marketing also. And when we talk about the publicity and marketing, which include the policies, strategies, coordination, supervision, promotion and marketing, hospitality programs. The functions also include the parliamentary work, establishment, and matters of the Directorate General of Tourism, as well as of the Ministry of Tourism, Government of India. Marketing and promotion is another backbone of the Ministry of Tourism to promote India in a holistic manner. As a part of its marketing promotional activities, MOT Ministry of Tourism runs campaigns in the domestic and overseas markets, organizes and extends support to the tourism-related events within country and outside, produces brochures, leaflets, maps, film, CD on various related themes and destinations, provide financial assistance to tourism service providers for undertaking promotional activities. Dear friends, domestic market is again an important area. Ministry of Tourism uses event as one of the important tool for promotion of tourism. The Ministry of Tourism organizes promotional events such as recently they have organized also the Bharat Parv, Paryatan Parv, with the objective to spread the message of Dekho Apna Desh, tourism for all, and to create the awareness about the importance of tourism. Of course, financial support is also extended to the events. They have the potential to promote tourism. Ministry of Tourism also organizes the different major events such as Bharat Parv and Paryatan Parv we have already discussed. And the intention of this entire theme is to propagate about tourism. And tourism is, when we talk about the tourism, these events play an important role. You know that Bharat Parv was organized at the Red Fort Lawn, and that was the time when it was coincided with the Republic Day celebration. Paryatan Parv 2018 was organized by Ministry of Tourism during the second half of September at national level. You know, 2019 they are organizing this, and we are more than 3,100 activities across 32 states, union territories were held. National Tourism Award. The Ministry of Tourism presents National Tourism Award every year to the state governments and to the tourism stakeholders for excellence in the field of tourism. Recently, this year also in 2019, it was organized in the month of September. Ministry of Tourism has in place guidelines for extending financial support for event organized at national and international level that have potential for promotion of tourism within the country. Yes, some people like to participate in exhibition. MOT also participates in various tourism-related exhibitions. Some of the important exhibitions include SATE, OTM, GITB. These participations are usually undertaken through India tourism offices. Domestic campaigns. In fact, Ministry of Tourism annually releases global print, electronic and online media campaigns in the international market under the Incredible India brand line to promote various tourist destinations and product of the country. Yes, the destination include north, south, east, west, and these campaigns are released in the important as well as potential source market for Indian tourism. When we talk about the domestic promotion and publicity, you know, you might have seen that in 2018, TV campaigns were released on Doordarshan, not only in the Doordarshan, even on the private channels also in the country for promotion of tourism, and with a specific stress on Northeast region and to state of Jammu and Kashmir. Yes, various TV campaigns were released on various subjects like, you know, recently the yoga, identified iconic site, Swachhta at tourist sites, Statue of Unity in Gujarat, digital outdoor campaign on Swachhta, you know, online campaign on Swachhta at tourist site for promotion of tourism in the Northeast region, promotion of Statue of the Unity. Specific certain programs were released, you know, campaigns in cinema house to promote niche product like yoga and to promote and publicize the other aspects, radio, SMS campaign and print advertisement for promoting Bharat Parv 2018 and Paryatan Parv. There is a Do You Know campaign released on Doordarshan to coincide the Paryatan Parv. Even, you know, photo contest like Musafir Ho Yaro, which is a very popular one, undertaken on Doordarshan to coincide with the Paryatan Parv. During the Paryatan Parv, this has been launched. You know, creative and collaterals, promotional film were developed on yoga, yogi of the rest track, wellness, reincarnation of Mr. and Mrs. Jones. These are very famous luxury, Maharani of Manhattan cuisine, you know, the Masala Master Chef. These are the very important and interesting program. You know, Wildlife, the Century in Paris. So these are certain names of campaign. India, the Land of Buddha, in association with the CNN. CNN is one of the prominent channel. You know, Kumbh Mela in association with BBC, British Broadcasting Corporation. And you know, Chennai, there is another thing, short films, television commercials, promoting wellness, adventure, spirituality, vintage car, wildlife, you know, heritage. India is very rich in heritage, the nature, royal residences, you know, produced in association with the BBC. And they are excellent in nature, by the way. Short film, television commercials, you know, on Red Fort, Qutub Minar, Badrinath, Kedarnath. These are the religious sites, pilgrimage sites, Gangotri, Yamunotri, including beaches of Goa, you know, church, convents of old Goa, you know, Ahmedabad Heritage City, Sanchi, which is again a prominent place, Bhimbatika, Elephanta Caves, Somnath, Konark, Tanjavur, and Konark, produced in association with the Discovery Channel, which is again an important one. You know, 2018, every year, by the way, they produce the wall calendar. In 2018, last year, it was an India at Night and Dusk calendar with theme that India for Everyone was prepared. Maps, different Indian map and city maps of Agra, Ahmedabad, Jaipur and Kochi, which is prominent in demand of the tourist. New television commercials were also produced. You know, as I told you, that different area, the niche area like wildlife, luxury, they all are aired globally and collectively registering around 190 million views on social media. This is very, very important when we talk about the publicity. And so far as overseas market are concerned, the Ministry of Tourism, Government of India, you know, Ministry of Tourism has at present 8 offices. Those are at overseas and they are positioning India in the tourism generating market as a preferred tourism destination to promote various Indian tourism products, like, you know, competition faced from various destinations to increase India's share in the global tourism. This is again a very important. So they have to critically examine those destination and the places those are tourist generating market. And these objectives are met through an integral marketing and promotional strategy. You know, a synergized campaign in association with the travel trade, state government and Indian missions. The specific elements of promotional efforts undertaken overseas include advertising in the print and electronic media, participation in fairs and exhibition outside India also, organizing seminar, workshop, road shows is again a very important promotional strategy, India evening, printing of brochures, collaterals, brochure support, joint advertising with their travel agents, tour operators, inviting the media and travel trade to visit the country. This is what we call the fame trip under the hospitality programs. You know, the Ministry of Tourism through its overseas offices, we call generally that India Tourism Offices. The intention is to position India as a preferred tourism destination in the tourism generating market to promote various tourism products and destination to increase the India share in the global tourism market. The objectives are met through an integral marketing and promotional strategy. And as we have already discussed, that this campaign has close linkage with the travel trade as well as the related agencies. Those are also actively working for the brand image of the country. When we talk about these promotion, all these promotional aspects have multiplier impact when we talk about Indian tourism, and it generates lot of funding. So dear students, I was discussing about the tourism promotion, especially the overseas promotion, and some of the countries are very important. Of course, Bangladesh has its own importance when we talk about the inborn tourist, but established markets like US, Europe and Pacific, South Africa, they are also very important. And these seminars, workshops, roadshows have a great impact when we talk about the creation of awareness among the people. The cultural festivals, food festivals are also being organized in different places. Brochure support to the tour operator, you know, and sometime they tie up with the airlines, they promote the tour operators and other organizations also. You know, this current financial year, Ministry of Tourism, Government of India has approved a series of promotional activities to aggressively promote tourism to India through eight overseas offices. And these eight offices are covering the entire world as such. International travel fairs and exhibitions are also being organized. And our offices of India Tourism, they always participate in these major travel fairs and exhibitions. And of course, these exhibitions further impact on the tourism generation when we talk about the tourist generating countries are concerned. You know, they catch hold the emerging and potential market to showcase and promote the tourism products of the country. And Ministry of Tourism utilized this opportunity to have the FAME Tour to ensure widespread publicity to offer maximum support of its tourism industry, even to highlight India's diverse range of tourism product, which is very unique. ITB Berlin, month of March 2018. Incredible India press conference was organized on 7th March 2018. I'm just referring certain latest information where Honorable Minister launched the new video on Yogi on the racetrack, which crossed 2 million views in just 2 days after the launch. Joint workshop on sustainable tourism development was organized by, you know, Federal Ministry of Economic Cooperation and Development, Embassy of India, Berlin. Again, it was in the last month in March. It was in the March 2018 last year. Promoting tourism from Germany to India and to increase the outbound football from Germany. WTM, very famous London, it was held in November 18. India has a, you know, India, when we talk about India, India is a land of colorful and vibrant festival. And people from across the country, the world rather, they wishes to see this. And this is an important part in the lives of every Indian as they celebrated by one and all. These celebrations reflect India's rich culture, tradition, and what better occasion to showcase the vibrancy of the various festivals of the country. Dance forms in Indian Pavilion at World Tourism Mart, London. You know, the Action Package Travel Trade event was held during this 3 days long event from 5th to 7th November 2018 in London. The theme of the Indian Pavilion last year was Festivals of India. Roadshow as a part of the promotional initiatives undertaken, roadshow are organized in important tourist generating marketing. You know, these roadshows comprises presentation and one-to-one business meeting between the trade delegates from India and the trade delegates related to travel to the respective country. So during last year, the 2018, Ministry of Tourism organized roadshows in different countries. A few I can name, like for ASEAN region, it was in Yangon, Myanmar, Ho Chi Minh, it is a city in Vietnam, Phung Phinh, Cambodia, it was in Bangkok also. USA, it was held in June 2018, New York City, Houston, Chicago, and St. Louis. China in August 2018, Beijing, Guangzhou, Wuhan, Shanghai, and public event in Shanghai, it was held last year in September only. Russia and Nordic countries in October 2018, you know, Moscow, which covers St. Petersburg, Helsinki, and Stockholm. Europe with Indian Convention Promotion Bureau, ICPB, it was held in June 18. This was held in Paris, Brussels, Geneva, and Zurich. Europe with Pacific Asia Travel Agent PATA, you know, India chapter in October 2018. It was held in Milan, Rome, Barcelona, Geneva, Paris, and Frankfurt. You know, India tourism offices overseas also organize No India seminar in like Tokyo, Nagoya, Busan, Buenos Aires, Argentina, New York, USA, Cardiff, Glasgow, among other. You know, not only this, the food festivals were also organized for promotion of Indian cuisine, which is an integral component of the Indian tourism product. Rather, foreigners love to have the Indian meals, food. And MOT extended support to Indian Food Festival by sponsoring the visit of Indian chefs to the different location. During the period, Ministry of Tourism sponsored chefs for the food festival in like Tunisia, Thailand, it was 5, Shanghai, Mexico, St. Petersburg, Moscow, Bangkok, Hue Hin, Chiang Mai, Hanoi, and so many other places. And when we talk about the outdoor publicity for greener and greater visibility of Incredible India, Ministry of Tourism, Ministry of Tourism has made certain efforts through their offices. We call the India Tourist Offices abroad, carried out airport branding. Like in New York, you might have witnessed this. Like Dallas, like Los Angeles, Dubai also it has been seen. Paris, London, Hong Kong, Sao Paulo, Singapore, and Bangkok. These are a few countries. Outdoor advertising was also carried out, you know, on buses, bus shelter, taxis, subway station, underground tube station. You know, digital screen billboards advertisement has also been put up, branding, online boarding passes of Air Brussels, etc. These things were undertaken by the ministry through its overseas offices. So in one way, you will find that Ministry of Tourism is aggressively working for the promotion of Indian tourism. Dear students, this entire discussion has referred certain references like FICCI report we have referred, and Indian outbound tourism unlocking the opportunity 2019. This is another important document. www.incredibleindia.org. This is an important website. tourism.gov.in. So these are certain things based upon which we have prepared this material. So dear students, what we have discussed in entire unit, if we wish to sum up this in a summarized manner, so this was an attempt to familiarize you with the Ministry of Tourism, Government of India, its functions, role, and how they are playing an important role for the development of tourism within country and overseas. Of course, we have also discussed the various functions, important functions, especially related with the specific marketing and promotional effort made by Ministry of Tourism in the recent past. I talk about the 2018, 17 or 19 onward. So they are very important for the domestic and overseas market. I'm sure this will be an important information for all of you. So finally, I wish to thanks all for your patience hearing and the listening.